Strongly that Fallout 76 is going to be a very hit or miss game. And after my time with the beta this last week, I fear that for many players it's likely going to be a miss, at least at launch. Bethesda Studios were kind enough to send me a code for Fallout 76 to play in the beta this last week. I don't want anybody to be railroaded into the conclusion that Fallout 76 has no redeeming qualities because it actually was a very enjoyable beta for me. Certain problems detracted massively from it. Most notably the performance, which we'll talk about here throughout this impressions video, but it still had some Bethesda Game Studios magic hidden within it. And I think there is a certain level of magic here with this game that, well, if Bethesda can support the title properly, may be able to pull out. But between performance problems and some odd design decisions, Fallout 76, well, it's a weird game. And I think you're gonna have to be a pretty big Fallout or Bethesda fan to wanna pick this thing up at launch. Let's just get right into the objective things like performance, and then we can dive into the design decisions, which is definitely a more opinion-based topic. I was playing this on the PC, and I went in with as open a mind as possible. I knew Bethesda warned us that this is going to be a chance to break their servers, for us to really try and break the game, and to expect problems galore. So I did. Come the first day of the beta, pretty much everybody on PC who had the title preloaded saw the game get deleted from the launcher about 10 minutes before the short beta window went live. And as you can imagine, when everybody and their brother is trying to re-download the game, it smashed the servers at Bethesda to the point where I had a 70-hour estimated remaining time left to download, other people seeing estimated times in the years. As comical as it might be, a lot of people were angry. I wasn't. I was disappointed, but again, I went in with that open mind and I was expecting nothing less. Well, I got in, I started playing the game. I'm on a GTX 1080 Ti and on a i7 6700K playing at 1080p. And on PC, sorry to say it guys, but the performance issues, there are a lot of them. Plenty of slowdown. You're not gonna see this thing running at a smooth high frame rate. Maybe for some rigs, that's a possibility, but I've heard of much more powerful computers having the same struggles that pretty much everybody else was having. There's no options for an FOV slider. You still have like a very limited amount of things that you can change from within the menu system. And you don't have the benefit of previous Bethesda games where you can just sort of mod away all the problems and go that route. And this is truly unfortunate because when you have a PC that is more than capable of playing a game built in such an old engine, it's detracting from the experience having such big FPS slowdowns and not having a stable, smooth frame rate. It's pretty bad on the consoles from what I have seen, and if I was having the issues that I'm having on PC, at least with the frame rate, I would not purchase the Xbox or the PlayStation 4 versions upon launch, at least until we see what those optimizations look like. And this is unfortunate as I was walking around Appalachia just pausing continually to look at the gorgeous scenery around me. Bethesda has made an upgrade to the light rays through the trees or whatever system they want to call it, and at certain points the game is drop dead gorgeous. I know a lot of people like to criticize some of the textures looking dated and it just not looking like a modern game, but I would disagree with that. There are points on this map which really is the true character of 76 that caused me to stop, stare, and just bask in the moment. Maybe it's because it's fall here and it's cold outside and when you get to see these great colors in Appalachia and the sounds of the wind and the trees, maybe it just creates a special moment. And then we dive into the gameplay. I don't think Fallout 76 knows what type of game it really wants to be. It's not a full-on survival game like Rust, and it's also not a full-on Fallout game, as there's no NPCs and the game really allows the world building to be told through audio logs that you find scattered throughout the world. And the only other living souls you bump into are other players. Ironically, on a really big, gorgeous map, I ended up bumping into quite a few players. I'm curious to see if this will be the case as the game gets a little bit more time behind it and players spread out in level distributions, because the map actually It's pretty big. One thing for certain is the Fallout or Bethesda magic is still present when you're traversing from point to point. Sure, the next objective may be a 2.5 minute run away, but it ultimately takes you 30 minutes because you get pulled over to this town after you hear a radio playing in the downstairs locker room. You ultimately find an audio log that opens up a side quest where you need to go hunt a camp of ghouls, and in doing so, you accumulate resources that you want to craft a new piece of gear or weaponry from. And before you know it, the game has pulled you off the beaten path and engrossed you in a whole, like, side story that's going on. This is common for anybody who's played a Bethesda game. It's core to the design philosophies of how they build their maps. And it is absolutely present in Fallout 76. The only difference here is the glaring absence of NPCs. And I think that might be a problem, because a lot of the characters in Fallout 4 generally were quite memorable, and those NPCs have big personalities that can be a joy to experience quest lines together with. I tried to play through the beta as a solo player. I do have friends that I'm going to be able to play this game with at launch. But I think it's sort of cheap when we do video impressions to say, well, it's probably better with friends. Everything is better with friends. Like, let's be honest here. You can say that about any game whatsoever. 76, though, is one of those titles that I don't know if it's going to pull you in that hard after the first 20 hours. Because with the lack of NPCs, and the general lack of identity with the game when it comes to its design decisions, it's not one of those survival PvP games where you want to grief each other. And it's definitely not one of those hybrid, beat the story, kind of Borderlands 2 style games. So what is it? Really? What is 76? I mean, people are playing Fallout 76 throughout this week and we're still asking the question, what is this game? And honestly, once that level distribution spreads out in the full release of the game, you know, you're not on a map that has 100 other players. It's kind of a low player count. So are you still going to be running into people? Ultimately, I think I fall in the maybe more minority of YouTube impression videos that left the beta actually pretty excited and looking forward to experiencing the game. But part of that is the sense of letting Bethesda have, you know, 6 months of support to see what they can turn Fallout 76 into. Because at this point, I can't honestly tell anybody to pick this game up at launch. In fact, I would encourage you not to, because of the performance problems. I want to see this game running smoothly on all platforms, and whatever that's going to take to get it closer to a more stable frame rate, it's got to happen. When you see Xbox footage at like 12 and 13 FPS at certain points, I have a leniency when it comes to Bethesda titles, but that is pushing it a little bit too far. And especially on PC, it always feels like you're kind of fighting the game, and that's unfortunate. Like I said, the true character at the center of the Fallout 76 plot is the map, and how well Bethesda is going to be able to keep you sucked into that loop and enjoying the map and exploring. I have a feeling that that charm is going to wear off not too long after the 10 to 15 hour mark, where I probably just don't care that much about this world and that space anymore, because well, everybody's dead except the other players around me. But from there, maybe that's when I start grouping up with buddies, building bases, trying to get a nuke, and seeing what we can do. If any of you had the chance to play the Fallout 76 beta this last week, I'd love to hear what you think about it. Is anybody getting any strong opinions just from watching the footage, for or against the title? Let me know about it in the comments down below. Please subscribe if you enjoyed this video and ring that notification bell. Subscription boxes haven't been working super well lately. Follow me over on Twitter, at BBKDRAGOON. I love talking with you guys there. Thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your day, and I'll check in with you again next time.
No, their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water.